Welcome back. Now that we know how power is generated in nuclear reactors, it's time to look at the safety aspects of nuclear power plants. Let's start with the overall safety goals, which are divided in technical and radiological goals. Technical goals are the control of radioactivity, the calculability, and the confinement of radioactive material, while the radiological goals are intended to limit both the emissions of radioactive substances and the radiological exposure of the plant operators by appropriate facilities and measures. The most important question is, how can these goals be achieved when designing a nuclear reactor? Today, we will look at the following three methods: conservatives in design, the multi-barrier concept, and the defense in depth concept. To ensure the confinement of radioactive material, the multi-barrier concept was developed. According to this concept, the uranium dioxide pellets are enclosed by different pressure-tight physical barriers to hinder any radioactive release into the environment. These physical barriers are the fuel matrix itself, the cladding, the reactor pressure vessel, and the primary circuit. The concrete shielding, the containment building, consisting of an inner steel liner and a reinforced concrete dome. You can see all of these barriers in the figure on the screen. Now, to prevent any release of radioactive material, the integrity of the physical barriers must be assured. For this reason, the defense in depth concept was developed. Remember that under normal operation conditions, the produced heat has to be removed. Only if there is an imbalance between heat production and removal, the local degradation of the safety barriers will occur. Safety assessments are required to investigate the effects of these imbalances. To ensure the reactor can be brought to a subcritical state at all times, two independent, redundant, and diverse shutdown systems are required. We will have a look at these systems inside a nuclear power plant, a pressurized water reactor. One system consists of control rods made of strong neutron-absorbing materials, such as boron carbide. The second system consists of a boric acid injection system, which ensures subcriticality if a scram fails. An emergency core cooling system is used to assure the coolability of the core in case of a loss of coolant accident. It consists of passive and active systems able to inject cold water into the core. All active systems take water from the flooding tank. It is a redundant system with four trains, each one with a 50% capacity, meaning that only two systems are needed to assure core coolability. The long-term coolability is achieved by the residual heat removal system. Once the flooding tank is empty, the sump operation mode is activated automatically by the reactor control and protection system. This means some water is injected into the core to remove the heat. And in this case, the sump water will heat up continuously if nothing else happens. For this reason, the residual heat removal system consists of interconnected circuits with active pumps and heat exchangers to remove the heat from the sump water into the final heat sink, which can be a river or an ocean. The defense in depth concept is the main pillar to ensure high safety levels, and it's designed in such a way that in case of any event, the plant is led to a safe plant state. For this purpose, both facilities and measures are developed for each safety level, considering the plant states. The defense in depth concept is based on a threefold approach: conservative design principles, and preventive and mitigative measures. First of all, safety levels are defined from 1 to 4. Normal operation, operational occurrences, design basis accidents, and beyond design basis accidents. Then for each safety level, a protection goal is defined. Next, the systems foreseen to cope with the event at each safety level are listed. Finally, the procedures developed for each safety level are defined. Safety levels from 1 to 3 are purely preventive, while level 4 is mainly mitigative. Safety systems are subjected to higher design requirements. The main design principles and their purpose are listed on this slide. Redundancy, for example, is helpful in case of single failure, while diversity in design is needed to improve the common cause failures. The fail-safe principle helps in case of loss of power supply, for example, for the control rods of a nuclear reactor core. Physical separation is essential against overlapping events such as flooding. Finally, automation in the nuclear power plant reduces the amount of human errors. I hope to see you in the next video, where we will discuss accidents in nuclear power plants.